Computing Probabilities in Minitab. Minitab has all the tables of your textbook built in. It goes beyond the tables because Minitab can handle any parameter values for whatever probability you need. Minitab has three output functions, so you'll need to use these in order to get the probability that you want. So sometimes you will have to use your knowledge of probability to compute the actual answer to your question. The first type of probability that Minitab can compute is an equals probability, like the probability that x equals 2. If you're looking for a cumulative probability, like the probability that x is less than or equal to 2, Minitab can also give you that, but it will not compute the probability that x is less than 2. Minitab can also compute an inverse cumulative probability. Let's say you're already given a percentile and you want to know what value of x is at that percentile. So the probability that x is less than or equal to what value of x will equal 0.75, or the 75th percentile. Minitab can give you that unknown value of x. Computing binomial probabilities. Let's look at an example where n is 4 and p is 0.25. Let's say we want to compute two probabilities. First, the probability that x equals 3. Second, we'll compute the probability that x is less than or equal to 1. And finally, we want to find out what value of x falls at the 95th percentile. Let's start with the probability that x equals 3. We will go to Calc, Probability Distributions, Binomial. At the top of the pop-up box, you can see the three different values that Minitab will compute. If we want the probability that x equals 3, that's a probability. We need to select that option. Next, we need to enter our parameter values. Number of trials is n. That was given as 4. Next, the event probability is p, 0.25. Please do not enter a fraction in this area. Minitab will give you an error message if you do. Since we're only trying to compute one probability and not create the PDF, we do not want input column. Instead, we'll choose input constant. It's here that we can enter the value 3, since we want to compute the probability that x equals 3. When we hit OK, the output will then summarize everything that we told Minitab to do. We're looking with the binomial distribution with these values for the parameters. Also, Minitab shows that we are computing a probability x equals little x. The little x that we were looking for is 3. Then Minitab tells us the answer. The second probability that we wanted to compute is the probability that x is less than or equal to 1. We'll go back into Calc, Probability Distributions, Binomial. This time we're looking at a cumulative probability. Since it's x less than or equal to 1. The number of trials and event probability are staying the same, since we're still dealing with the same example for the binomial distribution. But our input constant is no longer 3. We can change this to 1. Now we're telling Minitab to give us the probability that x is less than or equal to 1. We can see in the output, Minitab shows that it's a cumulative probability. And right underneath that is the answer. finally, we want to compute the value of x that is at the 95th percentile. We'll go back to Calc, Probability Distributions, Binomial. Since we were already given the probability, we want Minitab to compute the value of x. That's called an inverse cumulative probability. N and p are still 4 and 0.25. We need to change our input constant. This time we're looking for the value of x. The probability of x less than or equal to what value of x equals 0.95. The 95th percentile is what we're looking for. So the input constant then is 0.95. Then Minitab will tell us that value of x. When we hit OK, Minitab actually gives us two values of x. First, it tells us the value 2 gives a cumulative probability of 0.949. That's really close to what we were looking for, 0.95. Then it tells us that the value 3 gives a cumulative probability of 0.996. Since we're looking for the 95th percentile, 2 would be the best answer.